Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Techno Ed Learning. Today I'll be showing you how to create a puzzle of crosswords for your subject and share it with your students. Today's students have more diversity in learning styles. In response to different styles of learning, the use of games in classroom can be an effective tool. They can be used as a supplement to traditional methods of teaching and not as a replacement. Games can add flexibility to the classroom, allowing students to adjust to the way in which they learn best and have fun while learning. Today, I'll be sharing with you how to create crossword puzzle using Crossword Lab. Crossword Lab is free, fast, easy, and requires no registration. So let's get started. In the Google search, I have written Crossword Lab. Let's go to this first thing which says crosswordlabs.com. So I'll go here. Now, once I go here, you can see this screen. Okay. Now, this crossword lab could be used free of cost without any registration. Now, if I go to this login and sign up, to become a member of this crossword lab, I will have to pay a specific amount and then I can sign up to this crossword lab. But since there is an option in which you can use it freely without any sign up and without any paying any premium fees, so I'm going to use that benefit. Okay, now here I can even find, see you can see here, find a crossword. So if I go here, I have various options available, various subjects and topics in which I can go and find a crossword. So I'll go here. So I get a crossword already available for that particular topic, and this I can share with my students. Now I want to make a crossword of my particular subject. So I'll go to make a crossword. Okay. So here a crossword title, say airport engineering. Now how to write the word and the clue? Enter the word, a space, and then the clue. That is, and one word or clue pair per line. If you want to see an example, click here. See. Dog, space, man's best friend. Cat, space, likes to chase mice. So this is how you will have to write the word and the clue. Okay, so I've already written them to save my time, already written them in the text. I'll copy it. Okay, and I will paste here. Okay, so I can see here that a particular word and a space and then the clue for it. Now, if you could see here, it has come in two lines, which is not to be used like this. It is already written that one word or clue pair per line has to be there. So I'll have to remove that or decrease the clue. Okay. So I will say. Okay. So you could see here that word and the clue are in one particular line. Okay. So go below and you can see here there are various options if you navigate it through these arrows. Okay, various options in which I want the orientation of the crossword. So I'll select one orientation. Create a passcode. Now what is this passcode? This is if you want to view the answer key. Okay, no one else except me can be able to see the answer key of this crossword unless and until I have shared the passcode with them. Okay, so this is a password or a passcode for your answer key. So I will write some passcode. Okay. Then you can see here privacy settings. Since I have not paid any amount, I am not the member of Classword. Okay, so by default, the privacy setting is public. That is, which could be used only if you are using it for free. Other options, you can use it only if you are the members of the Crossword. Now I will say save and finish. So when I click on save and finish, I will then be able to see how my crossword will look and how I can share it with my students. See, you can see the crossword. You can see the clues here across down it has taken. Okay. Now here there are various options. If I want to zoom in, zoom out, then print or save it as PDF. Okay. I can do it. Then. Clear puzzle, that is if I have written anything in this puzzle and I want to clear it to start over again. So I can do this clear puzzle. I can show you an example. Also, see, this is what I am going to use it and write the answer. So rectangular area at the end of strip. If I write the answer as, if After writing the answer, you are supposed to press enter. If my answer is correct, it will show green. If my answer is wrong, it will be displayed in red color. And if you can see here, a cross is also given here. Okay. Now, second, long strip of land for landing or takeoff of aircraft. Right. Enter. Now, this answer is correct and therefore it is showing me in green color. You can see here a tick mark in green color. So, this is how we can view. Even the students can view this while solving the quiz. Okay. Then, I'll go to this and clear puzzle. Okay. So, it has cleared everything. Okay. Then, if I go to this edit, it will bring me back to my previous page where if you want to edit something, you can edit. If you want to change the orientation of the puzzle, you can change it, and again you can click on save and finish. Okay, then this is your focus mode where nothing else but only the crossword and the clues will be shown to you. Back, share. If I want to share it with my students, I can share directly this URL or focus mode that I have shown you, that nothing else except the puzzle and the clue will be shown. So this focus mode link can also be shared with the students. Okay. Then print. Print this page. This is print options. So the whole page will be printed. And you could see here the date is also given and the topic name and the crossword lab, all this appears here. And you can print it. Or you can print the Word and PDF version of it. You can even copy this crossword to your Word file. See, you can also copy this and paste into your Microsoft Word to customize it. Okay. Or see, if I want to print the answer key, I'll click here, answer key, and print. So this is how I get my answer key also. I can print that also. In advanced style options, I can change the border weight, number font size, answer font size, all those things here. Okay. This answer key is only available to me. If any student goes here and finds the answer key, tries to find the answer key, it will ask him or her to enter the passcode. Unless and until they have the passcode that I have given for the answer key, they cannot view the answer key. Okay. So this is how you can make the quiz, not quiz, but crossword labs instead of taking quiz, because it is more fun in learning and students will enjoy it while solving this crossword labs. Thank you so much. I hope this video will be helpful to you. Thank you.